Hi, welcome to Bradley's apartment. I am Bradley, and we're in my apartment. Continuation today, I was working on some studies of an otter. It turned out pretty good with the pencil sketching, so I went to colored pencil. Kind of mixing this up because I'm doing now the intros after I've done the drawing, because I've realized once I've started talking, I end up deciding not to use the medium that I said I was going to use, like pen or pencil or... So now I'm doing the intro afterwards. I'm doing a colored pencil otter. Videos to come. I don't know if you guys like the time lapse or just kind of long form. I'm hoping to make this more like a slow TV type vibe where it's just, you put it on, it's in the background, kind of pop in. Maybe I'll say something, maybe I won't. So today I am gonna continue with otter theme and I'm gonna draw this guy. I love his, like, cute but ferocious face. Doing it with a blue colored pencil, PrismaColor. Lock it on. I don't know if you can hear the birds out there. It's a little sanctuary in my backyard. It's crazy. So everything is light. I kind of like holding the pencil like this because it makes my pencil extra light. Little big, so we're gonna reduce the size. Bring this down. See, nothing is set in stone just yet. Still finding the shapes. Doesn't have a nice flow. Of everything I'm looking for to get. Bringing in a little more detail. That was my neighbor. Kind of see that. A little bit of a face going on. Now I always like to, since everybody always looks at the face, so you want to spend a little more time making sure it looks correct. No erasing yet. It's really fun when you get to a point where your hand responds how you want it to. Teaching your hand how to draw. And it actually responds correctly versus ending up looking like junk. Still, keeping it kind of light. A little more detail. Even light. The sun direction is from the top, so we're gonna, everything down here is gonna get darker. But for now, And some of the features are bigger than it actually is in the photo. This ear is bigger, but I think it makes them look kind of cuter. I don't know. We'll see. And I'm just kind of putting in there little hairs to make it already look kind of cute. There's a lot of blue highlights in the otter itself. Just don't want to lose. Just give you an idea. Maybe these marks will stay. No, I'm learning about colored pencils as I go along. I do tutorials. Most of the things, I mean, I had college and got my Bachelor of Fine Arts, but they had literally one illustration class. So it wasn't even an option. So I just went into graphic design. So I've been reteaching myself primarily through videos on YouTube. Reteaching myself. I did learn a lot. I had a lot of painting classes and drawing classes, like the basics, nothing like true illustration. It just wasn't even a major. Sharpen my pencil because thing I learned about color pencil, though, it's all about layering. It's also good to start with the blue because if you work in Procreate or any of the digital, it's really easy to bring this in, fade it back, and then do a line drawing directly into Procreate or any of the other drawing platforms. Really zoom in a little bit. So he's blue, and he's blue and brown. As always, a siren in the background. Personally, I love a monochromatic drawing. I think it's really pretty. I'll tell you another mistake I always make. I really want to do a hard line. Nothing feels better than doing a permanent line. Really dark here. I'm just going to remove a little bit off of this one. I don't want to do too much in here because it has the mouth open and then his tongue is all pink. Sometimes the blue and pink will get muddy. So I'm just going to leave that kind of open. He does have these hairs. See some personality. All right, little break. I'm gonna zoom in before I break. Let's see, zoom in. There we go. And I'm back. And as you can tell, I got too excited and I started working on it some more. Really got into the eyes. Starting to pop. Has a nice flow. Coming around through there. So I think it's coming together. It's not exactly how it is on the eyes are bigger. I made the eyes a little bit bigger than it is in the picture. Just to make it more pronounced. Also, it just like comes at ya. Mixing up with this metallic light blue, kind of bluish green. Sharpen it a little bit. Find one. I cannot. So yeah, he has a lot of whiskers. The whiskers look cool, right? Little dots just add a little something, don't they? Little details really make it pop, right? There we go. Since the sun is coming from above, I don't want to do too much detail on the head. too aggressive. Took it back. I'm gonna make it up here. There. Looking kind of cool. All right. Now we're gonna bring in a little bit of brown. Does this blue and brown look great together? That's cool. This is just kind of like a base coat of brown, right? That's how I did the blue. It's like the sun highlight on the top of the head right here. It's brown. Nice and soft. All right. I'm gonna finish this guy up on my own. Maybe I'll do another video tomorrow to finish it up. I think that's a nice start. I mean, the eyes are pretty great. And then the blue and the brown look pretty nice together.